Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Welcome to this edition of Shlokas Close to the Heart. This shlokam is a request from a dear friend Hema.
Manobuddhi ahankara chittani naham nacha shrotra jihve nacha grana netre nacha vyoma bhumir na tejo na vayuhu chidananda rupa shivoham shivoham.
A highly philosophical composition, the Nirvana Shatakam or Atma Shatakam is one of the gems composed by the Hindu philosopher Saint Shree Adishankaracharya. In part 1 of this 7-part series, we saw a brief history on the composition and the composer of Nirvana Shatakam. We also discussed about the philosophical nature of the Nirvana Shatakam and the meaning of Advaita Vedanta. In this video, let us look at the first verse.
Manobuddhyahankara chittani naham nacha shrotra jihve nacha grana netre nacha vyoma bhumir na tejo na vayuhu chidananda rupa shivoham shivoham.
Mano buddhya hankara chittani naham. Adishankara clearly says here, na aham, I am not. The mind, the intellect, ego or memories and reflections of the mind. Aham here refers to the true nature of the self or the jivatman. Manas, buddhi, ahamkara, chittani are the 4 subcategories of the antahkarana, the human mental scape or mind complex. The manas, the lower mind, is the place of thoughts and emotions, the way we experience this life. It constantly debates pros and cons and is swayed by likes and dislikes, habits and past experiences. The buddhi, the higher mind or intellect, is the seat of learning, analytical and reasoning capabilities. The part which can make informed decisions, even overrule likes and dislikes if they are not beneficial to us. We define ourselves as having something or being someone in order to establish how we differ from one another. I am a woman, I am a poet, etc. This tool of distinction is the ahamkara or ego. Each of us is a bundle of memories and experiences, attractions and preferences unique to ourselves. This inner field of experience or feeling is the chitta. With all these faculties, you and I experience the process of living as individuals. We say, these are my emotions, my thoughts, my intellect, my ego, my memories. So then, who is this I who possesses them all? Nacha shrotra jihve, nacha grana netre. Neither am I the sense organs of hearing, shrotra, tasting, jihva, smelling, grana, or seeing, netra. We experience the world through the 5 jnanendriyas, the organs of perception. Shrotra, ears, jihva, tongue, grana, nose, netra, eyes, tvacha, skin. From a unicellular plant to the humans, the sense organs are the tools helping us experience the world. So then, who is this I who possesses them all? Nacha vyoma bhumir na tejo na vayuhu. Neither am I the sky, vyoma, nor the earth, prithvi, neither the fire, agni, nor the air, vayu. The scriptures tell us that all creation is made up of a combination of 5 elements, the panchamahabhutas. Akasha, vyoma, is the sky, ether or space, vayu is air, agni is fire, Aap is water and Prithvi is earth. Shankaracharya says, I am none of the Panchabhutas. Although my subtle and gross bodies are made by the combination of these elements, they do not denote me. So then, who is this I who possesses them all? In the first 3 lines of the verse, Shankaracharya says, I am neither the mind complex nor the sense organs, nor the elements. As tools, they too belong to me. Then who am I? I am the soul, the Jivatman, says Shree Adishankara. Here the Acharya is conveying to us our true nature by negating all that we think of as ourself. We know that we identify ourselves as our mind, as our intellect, senses, etc. Only by individually isolating each of these and understanding that they are indeed operated by something more than themselves, can we arrive at the true master of it all. If I can understand and explore the mind and the intellect, then am I not different from them? If I can analyze and objectively break apart the essence of each of these elements and senses that I am made of, am I not different from them? Then whom do I identify with? What is my true nature? This is the journey Shree Adishankaracharya takes us through here. He refers to this true self as the Atman or the soul. What is this soul? Where is it? What is its true nature then? Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. My Rupam or form is that of Chit, cosmic consciousness, and Ananda, eternal bliss. Shivoham Shivoham. I am Shiva, the auspicious one. I am He, I am He. Shiva in Sanskrit means auspiciousness. The one supreme consciousness, the Brahman, is auspiciousness itself. Therefore, Shiva is the name used for Brahman here. Adishankara reiterates in every verse of the Shatakam that the true nature of the Jivatma is Shiva. He firmly states that our soul is a reflection of Brahman. It is Brahman. And it will truly shine forth as Brahman within each one of us when we can realize the truth for ourselves. Therefore, he says, Shivoham, Shivoham. I am Shiva, I am Shiva. If I am not the mind, sense organs or elements, then as the soul, where do I exist? What is my nature? We will continue to explore that in the next video. Hari Om.
Mano buddhi ahankara chitani naham nacha shrotra jihve nacha ghrana netre nacha vyoma bhumir na tejo na vayuh chidananda rupa shivoham shivoham.